There is a long recorded history for tea in China. The Chinese character Cha used to be Chu in ancient times, which appeared for the first time in oracles. Therefore, the archaeology circle has assumed that the Chinese tea culture began in primitive times. While the historians believe that the Chinese tea culture dates back to the 5th century AD, when Chinese merchants, in order to trade tea for other commodities, went on hikes all the way to Turkey. From then on, to the end of World War II, tea trade came into a complete commercial intercourse, and tea had always been playing the role of currency in this system. To nurture, attend, and pluck the tea leaves, supervise every step of tea processing, have it fermented, and finally find a good host, for it is each tea producer's greatest wish. As there are people who make tea, there are people who appreciate tea. Whatever they are tea lovers. You may be focusing your silent eyes on the tea leaves in the clear cup, rolling up and down time and again. Tea water from strong to mild, tea fragrance from heavy to light. It is just like the miniature of life, from desireful to desireless. You may brew a delicious pot of tea, basking in the sunny spring, and enjoying your well-being at ease between heaven and earth.
这次去武夷岩茶是在这个时间段的一个采摘。武夷茶呢，也是就是所有茶类里面做工最繁复的茶品，它集了所有的一个茶品的一个集合，要有红茶的韵律茶的香。武夷山的环境呢是非常特别的，它整体的就是我们从地理的一个位置上面讲，叫做一个丹霞地貌形式。 然后呢，它的一个山体结构的岩石，是因为造山运动所多少年沉积下来的那种岩石的养分，对茶树的生长是非常有利。还有一个就是武夷山的一个水分的一个充沛量非常的足够。然后历代的山民呢，是利用就是石缝、崖边，逐渐形成了现代的一个。 一个茶园模式，我们叫做盆栽式茶园。所以，类似于这样的一个体系，茶树在这个根系里面的一个成长，其实是造成了武夷岩茶现在的特有的一个口感的特殊性。Wuyi
Mountain is situated among the mountains at the south end of Fujian Province, China. Covering an area of 70 square kilometers, there are gorges and canyons in the mountain. Streams are zigzagging amidst. Seasons are distinctive and rainfalls are sufficient. All the tea products are crowned as a charm of rock. The intriguing natural surroundings, the unique features of tea that the climate has nurtured, and the mountain dispositions of stalactite fragrance are what scholars and calligraphers love and chase.
Hey, Chen 老师.
Hey,
你好，今天我们现在晒青，等一会儿由我的徒弟。
他带你们，他带我上山吗？上山。
哦，好的。是这位吗？
这位黄老师。
啊，黄老师。
哎，你好，你好。
你好，你好。
你好。
你待会儿等下就开车带他们去山上。
可以，我是
山上现在这个工人
说了，第一也有点天赋嘛，我觉得吧，可能也有点。没关系，我第一天来的时候，他叫我来的时候，我第一天就他教我一下，我觉得就会上手了。这东西，有的人要学3年到4年，他过来
现在在机器厂已经
比较欢迎，
查不赢了。
他也问了我们很多东西，
是这样子吧？
啊，我们也跟他讲了很多东西，比如讲说这个采茶怎么弄啊，
这个
还有
肉桂，
全部是肉桂，
这边全部
种到死坑里面的。因为我们眉山怎么有个三坑两件了，牛栏坑、马头岩。
你们平时就这么走啊？
我们今天头上那个地方是叫桂苑坑，采茶的时候条件一般就要到太阳了，下雨天就不好了。有阳光的茶，它等于就是做尾雕。就比较那个，就比较好做点，就有香气了，就有这样，就有茉莉花了。
Picked 3 days earlier, the tea would be treasure. Picked 3 days later, it would be garbage. Tea farmers know the most appropriate time would be before the Pure Brightness Festival, during which tea farmers would be heavily armed.To walk under the sun, because they know the tea leaves at this time of the year, after a whole winter's hibernation, bear sufficient organic nutrients and thus plump and tender tea buds, right time for picking. Over 1,000 years ago, Lu Yu, a Chinese scholar, wrote the classic of tea, in which he pointed out if the tea is produced in Zhenzhou.It is usually successful with excellent smells and tastes. Wuyi Mountain at that time was just in the neighborhood of Zhenzhou. Therefore, many classics and records also call it Jian Tea. Yet, Lu Yu never expected over the 300 years after his death. There have appeared some special tea making technique called Yao Qing.
标准的三叶一芽，这种三叶一芽的，它现在进行太阳导青。太阳导青的话，就我们说的这种紫叶面第二片，我们看第二片叶子标准啊，然后这个叶面失去光泽，丧失水分，然后它的这个叶脉自然下垂
啊。摇青工艺的是武夷岩茶制青工艺，非常独一无二的一个茶品工艺制作。这个过程是形成就是武夷岩茶它的一个花香果香特殊性香型品质特征及它的那个绿叶红香边的一个制作的一个特殊性的过程也是工艺的一个表现。
It is said that in times of transportation inconvenience, picked tea leaves were carried down the mountain in bamboo baskets. As the tea farmers slid and slid downhill along the rough mountainous road, the newly picked tea leaves were bumping into each other in the baskets. When they reached tea processors' hands, their edges became burnt red.The essence of tea is completely preserved. Tea producers at that time keenly noticed that and through various experiments simulated this procedure. During tea production, the tea leaves are wilted in the pot by low fire, then kneaded by hand to make the water in tea leaves evaporate. This innovative procedure was later called Yao Qing. Yao Qing was a great leap forward in tea producing history.From then on, half fermented tea appeared on the Chinese stage of tea culture.
我们最早学摇那个手工茶的时候，学手工茶要3年，那学开塞就要5年。摇青的方法比较规范，那规范的时候，我们拿塞的一个姿势标准，以及我们就是有技巧的，它不是紧握，它是比较松的握住。这时候你就还有技巧，用手腕的力量让青叶石在水塞上进行旋转。像我们这个，手上的老茧，这里全部都是，然后以及这里， 这里的话摸去都是老茧，还有这个位置最容易起水泡的几个位置，包括我们这只手也是一样，这个就是做茶人的双手。
This highly repetitive tedious actis just an important procedure of the entire rock tea production technique. The final effect of the repetitive shaking and scrambling is not to fail any green tea leaf. In the eyes of the tea friars, they treat the basket of green tea leaves as their own kids, letting them grow perfectly, trying hard to improve them, taking good care of them tirelessly.And delightfully well meaning for perfection.
画下面炒它就跟炒豆子一样噼里啪啦响的。哎，我试一下。好，我们先炒第一锅。啊，我们大概青叶一斤半。好，听到没有？要把它炒熟。好。然后因为锅温烫，所以我们抓是抓一些叶子放在手上，然后这样子翻。你千万不敢这个手贴到锅去啊，那种会破皮掉的啊。对啊，炒的时候千万不能粘锅哦，你这下面的话不能有这种粘住，粘锅的话它会什么？它会焦掉。揉成之后，它就这种形成这种条索，这种卷起来的这种条索啊。揉完之后啊，它不是成团了吗？我们把它打散来，你没把它抖散的话，它结块就成团，你到时候就没有好看的条索啊。它有一些墨就不要了，好，把面上的拿过来啊。你看它下面有一些在我们揉的时候揉碎掉的墨啊，墨子就不要了啊。我们要的是它的这种条索，然后你帮我拿一下。然后我们现在进行要这个叫背揉。我们现在把揉好的要把它摊到这个背篓上啊，然后进行等这个揉茶揉完之后，条索放在这里，然后之后再进入这种背间进行走水背啊，这就是到后面背茶。这种让它烤干，烤干的时候我们分也是要连分两道，一次性烤干的话它是偏薄，我们一般跑的到这八成干。
在制青的过程当中，它的一动一静的一个过程，动就是让它就是翻动滚动茶叶间的碰撞，这个叫做动。静是摇以后静置下来，静态放在那边静置产生的一个发酵的一个过程。
Like all other plants, the rock tea also likes water in the air. While absorbing water, it will also absorb smell in the water, which would cut into the taste of the tea. Therefore, after fermentation, it needs to be baked dry in the baking shop, letting the water and the smell evaporate together, and thus retaining its original taste to the greatest extent.That procedure is called Zhou Shui Bei. The assessment of the half-done tea products is an appraisal about the tea leaves before the second baking. The greatest ambition of the tea producer is to retain the color, fragrance,and taste of the tea, while the greatest expectation of the tea assessor is to figure out the color, fragrance, and taste. All this needs a taste bud for judgment. Conducting an appraisal on the same batch of tea leaves in preliminary processing, and then carrying out categorization based on taste. Planning about the baking temperature and length of time,for the second baking, trying not to fail any sip of the tea.
Actually, 其实每一批次的茶品，我们叫做每一锅做完的茶品，其实口感都是不一样的，所以需要制茶师的审评来恒定这个茶品在后面的一个制作工艺里面能够口感的平衡，甚至及时的发现，就是说这批毛茶里面的一些有杂味啊，香气度不高啊，或者它的跟它的特性啊，因为后面因为这一批的茶品，因为根据品种山草，制茶师是要根据他们来作为就是我们叫做统一的一个拼配啊，统一的一个制在后面的一个就是复备工艺的一个制作。如果你的茶品里面杂味香气不平均的话，那这个茶做出来就不符合市场的标准了。
再来一遍。它这种炭会烧得非常实，你看着它是炭，实际上就是说你看着它像煤炭，但是它实际上就是那个粒子
烧出来的。它的含水率过高，
它看起来非常。
它如果是说长时间存放，它会变质的。炭火打背是使它的炭完全燃烧了，再给它敲碎，敲碎了然后再加炭进去，然后再让它完全燃烧，然后再敲碎。这种是属于打明焙，打明焙的把大块的整块的那种大的炭头，这种木炭加到里面让它完全燃烧，烧红了以后给它敲碎。敲碎正常情况下我们一个焙坑差不多是100到120斤左右，会分4到5次加，就是说一次差不多再加个20到30斤左右的木炭，让它完全燃烧，然后再敲碎，一层一层，就像三明治一样，它可能就是说分几次加，加完之后完全燃烧以后，再给它烧完以后，在面上给它护灰，灰的厚度来控制它的火温，然后呢，在当天打完的焙的打完这个炭火，会让它完全燃烧。一个晚上使它温度均匀，然后等到第二天早上就可以开火，控制灰的厚薄程度来控制火温了，就可以开始焙茶了。武夷岩茶叫做这个半花轿的乌龙茶，它在初制过程中实际上是起到伤红驱力，然后起到一个半花轿的一个效果，但是呢它没有通过焙火的茶，它始终它是属于一个我们所说的就是半生熟的一个状态，它有清香，它都低会点的香，就是说香气它会比较清淡。
成品的武夷岩茶的形成是就是我们叫做黑褐色油亮，它的香气干茶香气清透，它的就是汤感的是我们叫做要水中香，香气的高雅单纯活性好，这个是体现茶品的一个就是说高质量的一个标准。
3-year rock tea is tea, 5-year rock tea is medicine, and 10-year rock tea is gold. The longer it is stored, the better the taste is, and the more nutritious it is. And the key to storage depends on the duration and degree of the baking. Overbaking produces a burning smell. Underbaking results in sour taste, jamming the fragrance from emission. The effect of baking is to further dry the tea leaves, making the rate of water under 5%. The appropriate rate of water prevents oxygen. Over or under rate would promote oxidization. That is one of the reasons why the rock tea with qualified baking can be kept for a long time in normal temperature.
这个差不多这样大小，
这种草编的话是用到哪一种？从最底部的味道。
也要是这个吗？
这个因为所有的茶品的特性是忌杂味，就是你不能有香精的味道，不能有铁锈气的味道，不然的话你进入茶企以后 它茶会吸附这个味道，那你茶皮就不干净，不醇厚了。以天然的质地的东西来装茶是比较符合的，因为它上面没有任何的一个就是说化学级的一个味道呈现。然后当时甘老师的一个制作是，因为他也是非物质文化，他的一个制作工艺是非常精良的，编织非常体，我是喜欢比较精致的东西的，所以跟武夷岩茶的一个结合，我觉得是比较贴切一点。
我们这个做传统的粘度就是一种瓶柱啦，就是花样是有的，但是这个跟这个茶片套粘不一样了，它里面有弯弯曲曲，里面有还有套进去的东西，这个也有一点难度。里面因为有它这个茶边要镶进去的嘛，就是跟我们的传统的有点不一样。像让我也尝试了一下一种工艺品的东西嘛，所以我很感谢和你们这样合作，我觉得很开心。我也是第一次尝试。
林布 under 陈铎 ancient Chinese poets complimented in their poems as the grinding stone breaks the tea like foggy dusts. The milky water produces delicious jianqi tea. Wuyi mountain witnesses tea leaf picking in the rain. Tanned leaves with hairs to receive good fame since ancient times.
好甜，然后他呢已经把当年的那个噪点去掉了，他很内敛的。等到用热水激发他的时候，我就觉得他所有的香气，大红袍特有的那种桂皮的那种香味，全部沉入水中。然后我在入口品，有一个活力，然后那个茶香，它不是很飘扬的，能够落水，让我的心能够静下来的。然后后期入喉的话，它没有那种干涩感，然后没有辣喉感，就那个就舌底抿拳，就让我不停地分泌那种唾液，让它就是很滋润、很甘又很甘甜的，带给口感愉悦的那种，我就觉得是好茶。
People admire tea since ancient times, as they admire.The lofty and unyielding nature with the fragrance and without swanking. They also admire the somewhat bitter taste as it first enters the mouth and a sweet flavor afterwards, like the miniature of life. From the bud to the teapot, each tea leaf is just like an immortal from the heaven.Bound together with the tea producer through difficulties and hardships, living through winds and rains, under the scorching sun, under the long waiting in loneliness, until one day, when it is unsealed, it bursts into brilliant bloom in the water. This stands by heaven and human, eventually turns into sweet dew, whispering.through taste bud to everyone that delicately appreciates it.